Hi guys, it's Amy. Welcome back to my channel. Today I am doing a pocket page with the newest release from Feed Your Craft, the Feeling This kit. And I'm just showing you the flip side of the spread. And it's kind of funny that this particular layout is going on the back side of that spread I just showed you, because that was actually documenting a time where it was kind of like a blah couple of days for me. And then the backside now is going to be another blah sort of spread as well, because my rough couple of days actually turned into like a rough week or couple of weeks, I guess you could say. So yeah, I had already been in a bad sort of mood, I guess you could say, for the past couple of days. And then this particular morning that I'm documenting now, I got a call from my son's school that he was running a fever and sneezing, so they wanted to send him home. I went and picked him up, and his fever lasted throughout the day, and then the next day I got the fever, and then the day after that my daughter did, and we all had runny noses, and it was just sort of a blah week. And then, you know, then we had to be on distance learning on top of it. So that's what I'm kind of documenting here. And thankfully it was mild and nothing super serious, but yeah, I'm just going to document that week. And I think this is a great kit to do it with. So I'm trying to decide on what kind of colors I want to go with. And I really like that deep green in the kit, but I'm being pulled more to the blues. So I'm going to go ahead and work with the blues. And I'm going to do my journaling on that top 4x6 card that says OMG, what the heck, or WTH. And then what I'm doing here is I've taken out some of the stamps from the stamp set, and they're just little sentiments. I can't quite remember exactly what they say. I think one says like exhausted and the other one says stressed or something like that. Or maybe it's so over this, one of the two. And I'm bending them slightly just to go around the curve of my head. I kind of like how that's kind of playing off, you know, thoughts in my head. And then I also like that it ties in that curved sentiment that's on that deeper blue card that's right next to it, the one that says it's just a bad day, not a bad life. It has that sort of arched look to it. So yeah, I'm just kind of gonna mimic that on this photo by just stamping directly onto the photo itself. And I've gotten a question about this before. I use a selfie printer and the photo is pretty glossy, and to stamp all my photos I use this archival ink pad. But here's the thing, it's very old and dried out, so I don't know if that's why I'm able to stamp on it, on my photos with it, is because it's not very saturated. Catherine Pooler's ink pad in Midnight, you guys know I like that ink. It is very saturated and super like pigmented and juicy, I guess. I'm sorry, I hate that word, juicy. Anyways, it is, and it slides a lot. So yeah, I kind of just like to use my dried out ink for that. Maybe that's weird, I don't know. And then also, just when you're stamping on photos, I found that the best is to go like, you don't have to go hard. That's also one of the mistakes that I've made, is thinking that I have to, you know, make an impression super hard. If you go super hard and press down, that is when you can tend to slide. So just go down, straight down and straight up. That's how I found that's the most helpful to stamp on my selfie photo paper. But yeah, so I've got those little sentiments stamped around my head, and then I added a little asterisk as well, and that's also from this stamp set. And then I went into the sticker kit, or the sticker kit, the sticker sheet that comes in the kit, and I pulled off this little navy blue sticker that says "This sucks," and I thought that that kind of brought that deeper navy color down lower on the spread for me. And I'm gonna stick that on that 3x4 card with all the little sad faces on it. And then I also tore off the broken heart from the sticker sheet as well, but I wasn't loving it. I didn't really like the white border around it. So I grabbed a little felt heart I had from my stash and gave it a staple, and I like the way that that looks. And then here I'm gonna go again and play off that sort of bent stamp that I've got going on here. And I'm gonna bend one of the little stamps that says, "Oh no," and I'm gonna bend it around the edge of that picture of my thermometer. That's a picture, I took a picture when I checked my own temperature the next day and I had a 99.1. So snapped a little quick pic of that, and then Yeah, I like the way that that looks. I like how it's kind of cohesive with the kind of semicircle look going on there. But after that, I'm going to call this layout done. I know this was a short video today, but it came together really quick, and I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.